وعليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. في كل زمان وفي كل مكان. I'm still in the first visit in Iraq in 1996 when we were trying to distribute the Qurbani carcasses to the people. After we have exchanged the dollar in the black market, the value or the amount of money that we made was equivalent to 600 Qurbani, not only 300 Qurbani. So on the day of Eid, I have learned quite a lot. The day of Waqfa, which is the night of the Eid. My colleague, as a volunteer from United States of America, young man, was very handsome, very elegant, very, يعني, whatever they call him, and loved to spend some time in the shower and loved to wear very nice clothes. And most of the clothes were actually light colored, like creamy, like white. The socks were white. And he did not want to make his hand dirty at that time. My mistake is I failed to make an induction to him to let him to understand the situation in Iraq. This is my failure. I admit it. So when we're trying to load the animals onto the vehicles to send it to the mosque in Hayy al-Thawra, Thawra area, to be slaughtered the following day, I was trying to engage him because the workers were putting the animals on the trucks and were counting every one of them, and they were sitting for watching them. Well, you know what I have done? I have done a very crazy act. I just hold one of the sheep in my hand, and I told him, Aftab, said, what? Said, hold. And I throw the sheep to him, and he have to jump in the air because he is very strong and powerful, and hold it to try to save him from falling down. And after that, his sweatshirt or t-shirt become dirty, and he started to get into the mood of actually helping the people there. And we loaded the 600 Qurbani on the trucks to go to the mosque. In the mosque, I did another mistake. I did not have enough volunteers to observe the process of slaughtering and counting the carcasses and counting the mi'laq. What is the mi'laq? Al mi'laq is what we take as one piece: the tongue, the gullet, the lungs, the heart, the liver, the spleen, the kidneys, and the testicles. And at the end of the day, I found that there's not many of these mi'laq in the mosque. Only two barrels of filled with them, maybe about 20, 30 in each. But the rest, I don't know where they have gone. And I asked the imam, said, this is the only thing that we have here. I will not mistrust the imam. And I believe that imam could have been sending it to the musallin or to the people in the area to distribute it on our behalf without telling us. But anyway, this is another failure. No matter who is your partner, you have to get people to observe the process of slaughtering and the process of distribution. And this is what I failed. Only two people to be there to observe 600 carcasses to be distributed is wrong, and it's a big mistake. The third lesson which I learned on the morning of the Eid, I went to pray with Aftab into the mosque of Maqam Sidi Abd al-Qadir al-Jilani. And for yourself and myself, I have not seen any man or any young child wearing new clothes, new trousers, new shirt, new shoes, even new slipper. This was not Eid. This was a fatal and this was more painful than slaughtering my neck, like actually used to slaughter the animal there. Why? Because Iraq is one of the richest countries, not only in the area, but in the whole world. One of the most educated people, unfortunately. And how on earth they become like that? None of the people who came to pray the prayer in Sidi Abd al-Qadir al-Jilani Mosque was wearing this kind of just something to express the feeling of Eid. The second very painful lesson which I learned at the time, after we finished slaughtering the 600 animals in the area inside the mosque, I went to relax under the shade of the, there was a shade in the mosque, and to relax because we started to work from about 7 o'clock in the morning till about 4 o'clock in the afternoon. And Aftab was making the distribution inside Baghdad. I found an Iraqi woman, noble woman, but poor, wearing the traditional black dress, and she's looking around right, left, and she did not want to let anyone to see her. I was very curious. I did not want to show her that I'm observing her. And she was picking something up, putting it in a bag with her, picking up. And you know what I realized? That she was picking up from the floor with the dust, with the sand around it, the intestine of the sheep. Because on the day of Eid, this noble Iraqi woman wanted to bring anything which could be related to the meat, as a meat itself, even to make soup for her children. This is not the situation of the Iraqi people at that time. Iraqi people, and Iraq is one, and still, one of the richest country on earth, most educated, but how on earth they reached that at the day? So it was very painful for me, all these lessons to happen to me on the same day in Baghdad, inshallah. And I will see you in another episode, inshallah, in another episode.